What's the best thing to do with your old Christmas tree? Yes.
I put mine back in the spare room. I do, and it's still fully decorated.
Oh, so you have an artificial one?
Of course.
Oh, I see.
I just unplug it and then put it all in. So in my spare room, it's always Christmas.
Oh. Well, imagine if it was a real tree rather than an artificial one. But it's rather pleasing. It's actually possibly the best thing you could think of doing. Give it to a zoo. There are animals that would love it. In Germany, they do this regularly. In
Britain,
elephants. Elephants love it. An elephant can have 5 Christmas trees for lunch. 5 Christmas trees. And giraffes, rhinos, a Dresden Zoo camel, deer, sheep also enjoy it. So before London Zoo writes me a letter saying, what the hell have you done, Stephen? Entire Regent's Park is covered. Ring up the zoo first and ask if they'd like your Christmas tree. But as long as it isn't too covered in hideous bits of silver tinsel and got rid of all the nastiness.
How much cuter that elephant would look if it had a little bit of tinsel on it.
Well, it might look cuter, but I don't think it's nutritively valuable for
You know what tinsel is? Mirrors for snakes.
Oh. You are building the world's first ice rink, so you're going to need a rink and some... Josh!
Well, I've never seen this show before, so this can't go wrong, but... ice.
Yes. Yes!
No!
Yes! 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 Play the pig. Why do you think you need the pig?
Oh. I didn't like to show my working, so...
Bacon
you don't
ice.
Know the ice is safe to skate on, so they'd slide a pig out and see if it would go through. And if it's safe for the pig, it's safe for the kids, right?
Pigs can ice skate.
Really well.
A few of them.
They go on their backs, so they screw down at the ice.
What did you say, though, Noel? You said...
Bacon
pig
ice.
Yes.
That was quite abstract, I know.
And weirdly is the correct answer.
I feel like I'm the nana at the table. You've just given that to me as some sort of...
Bailey's for Nana.
The very first artificial rinks, they didn't have the technology to freeze large amounts of water. It hadn't been invented. So the ice, in inverted commas, was made of pig fat and salt. So the Glaciarium, which is the world's first permanent artificial ice rink, it opened in Baker Street Bazaar, Portman Square, 1844. It was 1 shilling to get in and 1 shilling to go on the ice, except look at the wonderful kind of notice they put at the top. They put not ice. Not ice. So there was alpine scenery painted on the walls, but you did have to put up with the smell of pig lard, basically. So,
yeah. That would be all right.
It wasn't until 1876 that they developed the technology to freeze large amounts of water. It was developed by a man called John Gamgee. He was a vet and an inventor, and he had been trying to find a way to freeze meat so that he could transport it from Australia, and he suddenly realised that his technology could be used for recreation.
I bet the pig sent him some flowers.
And he had this wonderful tent off the King's Road. He had a live band to entertain the skaters. It only lasted 2 years, but the technology that he invented is very similar to the system used in ice rinks today. The only problem was in the summer, the ice used to evaporate and people used to skate around in a bit of a fog. You couldn't really, see each other.
Exciting.
Yeah.
Like stars in their eyes.
Oh, I love that bit.
Tonight I'm going to be Torvill and Dean.
Yes.
Tonight I'm going to be Jack the Ripper.
What suffers most at the office Christmas party?
I have to say, this the photocopier from having certain glasses on it.
It's the right answer! Yep.
Oh, say!
I was going to say, that was a long photo shoot for me, that was.
There is a 25% increase in emergency call-outs around the 2 weeks leading up to Christmas. And Canon, they've done a survey about this, and it's absolutely astonishing how much people abuse their photocopies at Christmas parties. It's not just a myth, people really do it.
Has the Queen got a photocopy?
She she uses a portrait artist whenever she needs anything duplicated.
Wants this page painted in half an hour. Two copies, A4. And,
the rather splendidly named canon engineer Jeff Bush says that he's had glass broken due to young ladies copying their rears. They've found sleeping cats inside the copiers, a snake, a kitchen knife, a sausage roll, a condom, stockings, a vibrator, and even a cheque for £6,000.
Why the hell? Who put the cat in? No, I can understand.
A copycat.
Yay! Maybe they lifted it up because there was a paper jam because somebody...
Go in there, Tiddles, and clear that up, yeah. His little paws would get at the toner faster. Like, and he'd get to reach and tug
it. It is a peculiar thing to find. A snake is odder in a way, because...
But maybe, do they send in the snake to clear out the cat? Is this like...
Technically, though, I think you can fax a snake.
I want to know what winterval is. Does winterval mean anything? Do you ever heard of it? Yes.
Political correctness gone mad.
It is a special law. If you get every one of these, they're completely null and void.
But no, it's this typically British thing. I guarantee, probably, if you're reading a newspaper today, round about Christmas, there will be some tiresome old fart who will have written about, you know, there aren't any more office parties, and for political correctness reasons, there are no decorations in offices, and they're calling it winterval so as not to offend minority religions. It's absolute bollocks. It just isn't true. 95% of all offices are decorated. There have been more office parties year on year, every year. And Winterval was simply a commercial campaign.
Oh, yeah.
What was that?
Yeah. Novelty logos.
Something just ran across there really fast.
Yeah. I think it was a velociraptor.
But that's the point. It was a promotional campaign. It was nothing to do with...
I remember the Birmingham City Council.
Birmingham City Council,
My brother was on the phone to me. He's going, yeah, bloody Birmingham City Council, the Winterval, the PC, gone mad.
And it's all nonsense. It wasn't anything to do with that. It was a campaign for local businesses. It was just a thing. We'll, you know, from November to January, we'll...
Thank you.
You're very upset by that, aren't you?
It's running all the way around the building. We'll be back in a minute.
Oh dear.
Hey, so, just doing that. Wait for him. Just
okay.
Could be ages.
I don't want to look at that one now because I miss it. Forget it. He's not coming.
Don't change channel.
Now, why is Santa off the rich list?
Poor Santa. Cutbacks.
Austerity
drive.
Austerity drive.
Only works one day a year.
Only works one day a year.
As he developed
he used to be on the rich list. He used to be on it until 2006. Forbes magazine famously invented virtually the idea of a rich list.
Is there some...
Yes, young Brendan.
Is it because he may not be real?
Have you dreamt of this?
Thank you!
Oh, poor Phil. Phil, that got a klaxon, so that can't be right.
Don't worry, back you go.
Yeah. Oh, little soul. Forbes magazine genuinely publishes a fictional rich list. And Santa Claus used to be on it because they reckon he must be infinitely rich because he is able to distribute presents every year to all the children of the world, they said. I don't believe he does. I don't know why they...
Richie Rich.
That's Richie Rich, of course.
Scrooge,
I guess, on the left. Father Christmas himself in the... You know,
the late Bernard Manning on the right.
Can you name? I've got the top five. Name any in the top five that you imagine might be on the
real riches. People or imaginary
no fictional.
Ones.
That's the point.
Scrooge McDuck.
No, but number two is the enemy of Scrooge McDuck. good one. Flintheart Glomgold is his name.
Flintheart
Glomgold. Yeah. And number one,
played
Benedict Cumberbatch, Benedict. The richest fictional creature in the world, human or they now in the audience?
Smaug.
Smaug with the dragon in The Hobbit. $62 billion worth of gold he sits upon until, of course, he... Well, I'm not going to tell you the ending. Because I have
to be in it. Don't spoil it.
But why is Santa taken off? Because surely he must be really rich to give everyone a present.
It's a very simple reason.
Tax Forbes, evasion.
Not tax evasion. It's the usual answer. Because it's a fictional
And he's
list,
real.
And Santa is Santa real.
Is real.
Oh, Forbes decided that. So there you go.